Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to create a triangle pattern from a photo in Adobe Photoshop. And then I'll show you how to make kind of a halftone dot pattern, although it's sort of a fake halftone dot pattern. All right, let's get started. Okay, I've downloaded an image from pexels.com, and I'm just going to click and drag that onto my Photoshop icon. I'm going to open my layers palette by going to Window, Layers. I'm just going to use a section of this photo. So I'm going to get on my marquee tool and choose the rectangular marquee. And I'll just draw right around her like this. And then I'll hit C on my keyboard, which will bring me to the crop tool. And then I'll just hit enter or return twice. Now this layer is locked, so I'm going to unlock it by just clicking on the lock button right here. And now we need to convert this to a smart object. So to do that, I'm going to come up here to the layers flyout and choose convert to smart object. And you won't notice any difference over here, but you might have noticed that there's a new little icon on our layer. And that means it's a smart object. Now we need to add a new adjustment layer for the background. So I'm going to click down here at the bottom of my layers palette and choose solid color right here. I'm going to choose black. And then we'll say okay. And you can see we've got a new layer now. It's got a little mask over here, and then here is where we can change the color of the background if we want to. So I'm going to click on this and drag it below the photo. And now I'll click on my photo layer again. I want to make a pixelated mosaic out of this picture. So to do that, I'm going to come up to Filter, Pixelate, and Mosaic. I'm going to hit Command Plus and zoom in a little bit. That's Control Plus on a PC. If we get really close in here, you can see that each little square is its own color. Okay, so I'm going to increase the cell size. Let's zoom back out a little bit. That seems a little much. I want to keep some of her features. So I'm thinking 35 looks pretty good. Whatever cell size you decide, you'll need to remember this number. So just keep it in your mind. Mine is 35, and we'll say okay. Now we'll need to create the pattern. So to do that, I'm going to create a new file. We'll go to File, New, and now you'll need to make this document the same size as your cell size. So mine was 35, so I'll just change this to 35, and the height to 35 also. You'll want it to be a perfect square. The resolution will be 72, and the background can be white, that's fine. So we'll create. I'm going to hit Command 0 or Control 0 on a PC to fill the canvas inside the frame. I want my triangle to come exactly halfway, so I'm going to hit P on my keyboard to get to my pen tool, which is right over here. And I'm going to click right here in the corner. I'll hold Shift and click down in this corner. Then I'm going to go a little below this corner and finish the shape. Now I'm going to open the Paths window. If you don't have Paths open, that's going to be under Window, Paths, right here. And all of these other windows will also be available under Window if there's anything you need to open. So we have a work path here. I'm going to double click this and just hit Enter or Return to make a new name for it. And that kind of saves it to the document. Now I'm going to Command or Control click this little image part of that path. And you'll see it's highlighted it. Now I'm going to make a new layer in my layers window, and I'm going to hit D on my keyboard to get a black foreground color and a white background. I want to fill this area with black, so I'll hit Option Delete. That's Alt Delete on a PC. And now we can hit Command D or Control D to deselect. And this is the first pattern that we're going to use. So we'll come up here to Edit, Define Pattern, and we'll say okay. Now I'm going to come back to my other document with the photo in it. I'm going to make sure I'm clicked on the photo layer again, and I'll go ahead and add a mask to this. It's right down here at the bottom of the layers window. Make sure to click right on that mask, not over here on the image, but on the mask itself. We're going to fill this with the pattern we just made in the other document. So we'll come up here to Edit, Fill. We want our contents to be pattern, and then we'll want the custom pattern. Scroll down to the very bottom, and it should be the very last one in the list. So I'll click that and choose OK. And now we have our color triangle pattern, and if we zoom in on this, Each triangle is 100% of a color, so there won't be any gradient areas. And that's exactly what we want. And the reason this has happened is because we made the pattern document the same size as our mosaic cell size. Now our background is also editable. So we can click right here on this black box, double click it, and choose a different background color. I'm kind of liking this very dark brown. Yeah, that looks nice. All right, let's go back to the same document we already created, and we're going to make a few different dot patterns. So I'm going to hide this top layer, and I'm going to change the background to black. So I'm on my background, and I'm just going to make sure black is in the foreground, and then hit Option Delete or Alt Delete. This time I want a circle, so a dot right in the middle. So to do that, I'm going to get on my little ellipse tool down here. I'll get right on a corner, and I'm going to hold Shift and drag this circle all the way out to the edge. And it's added an ellipse layer in here. So now I'm going to change the fill color to white. I'll make sure I'm clicked on it, and then I'll come up here at the top and choose white. Now we can just go ahead and go to Edit, Define Pattern, and say OK. We can also take a look at our patterns. You can get there by going to Window, Pattern. And I think I want another one just like this, but a little more inside the black. So I'm going to take that same ellipse, hit Command-T or Control-T, get on a corner and click and drag. You might want to hold Option or Alt, and that way you can resize from the center. And some of you might need to hold Shift to constrain proportions, although my Photoshop is not set up that way. Okay, so we have a much smaller dot now. I'm going to go ahead and come back up here to Edit, Define Pattern, and say OK, and that adds it to my patterns. Now the last thing I want to do is do a custom shape like a heart. So I'm out here on Vecteezy.com, and I've already found this heart. I'm going to go ahead and download this. Free license, and it takes a moment to download. We'll have to go out to our downloads and unzip this by double-clicking or right-clicking and choosing Extract or Extract All. I've got an EPS here, and that will work great. So I'm going to go back to Photoshop. I'll hide this ellipse layer. I'm going to go to File, Place Embedded, and I'll navigate to that vector heart. I'll choose the EPS file and place. And it puts it in there exactly the size of my canvas, which is great. If your heart isn't wide enough or isn't tall enough, I just go ahead and stretch it out to the edges. Now I want this heart to be white, so I'm going to Command or Control click it, start a new layer, and then fill that with white. Since I have white as a background color, I can hit Command Delete or Control Delete on a PC. And now I'll just hide that gray heart. We'll come up here to Edit, Define Pattern, and say OK. So we have three new patterns here, and now let's go back to our photo layer to apply those patterns. I'll need to get on my photo layer and then click on the mask. And first I'm going to try this large dot. So we'll come up here to Edit, Fill, Pattern, and then we'll choose our large dot pattern and say OK. And this looks pretty nice. When we zoom in, we can see they are all one color. Let's try that same thing, but with the smaller dot. We'll make sure we are clicked on the mask. We'll go to Edit, Fill, and choose that smaller dot pattern. And this one gives a little bit of space between each of the dots. And now let's try the heart. Edit, Fill, and we'll choose the heart. And that is a pretty neat little effect too. So you can really use any white shape you want for this. I would make sure it fills up most of the cell. Otherwise, you won't be seeing much of your photo's colors and it'll come out looking kind of dark. All right, if you like this video, please click on the like button and I'll see you in a couple days with another graphic design tutorial. Thank you.